Whenever people ask me what do? I always say I'm a designer because that's what I've been, you know, studying. That's my background. That's how I identify myself. But honestly, if you think about this, I'm more of a business owner, both at my freelance business and more importantly at our product business, Prospero. And that kind of difference between mindset is often recently, I'm understanding, causing me troubles, because as a designer, I want to focus on the things that I love, you know, making things more useful, making things look better, solve design problems. But design problems are not always the most critical thing that you should do if you run your own business. Yesterday I had a meeting with a CEO that I really appreciated, and I kind of shared him where we are with Prospero at the moment, shared some stats, our conversion rate and stuff like that, and what we're working on right now. You know, I've been sharing with you that I'm working on a redesign of our wizard component in our product, and I'm really excited about this. You know, I've shared with you the process. I want to add more features. I want to make this experience much better, and I'm super excited about this. But he told me, wait, I think you're working on the wrong thing, because from the stats that you're showing me, your product is actually working pretty well at the moment as it is. Do people actually complain about this wizard that you're working to improve? And I said, well, nobody's really complaining about this, but I know that it can be much better. And he said, yeah, it can be much better, but there's things like, you know, integration with maybe invoicing software that can like blow up your distribution and like 10x your user base, and that will make a huge difference in your business. So maybe you should be focusing on that rather than, you know, solving design problems, which are, you know, they might be important, but they're not like the best thing that can help your business at the moment. And that really kind of opened my eyes. And so I went on to research the biggest invoicing software, and obviously they already have some integration with proposal software. And so I was looking at, you know, where you discover kind of like the add-ons on the apps page, and all you see there is a logo and kind of a title and a little explanation about the software. And all of a sudden I was saying, okay, if we're gonna be here, then maybe we have to stand out. Maybe we need a better logo. Maybe we need to change our name to something that is more, you know, will stand out more, because this is actually where we're going to compete on this like app market page. And as you can see, immediately my designer mindset wants to focus, wants to go back to projects like branding projects, renaming and stuff like that. Things that I know how to do well, that I want to, you know, that are fun to me to do, rather than, you know, work on API and business development and stuff like that, which I'm not like super passionate about. And so I really have to keep myself focused if I want my business to succeed. If I want to be a good businessman and not only a good designer, I really have to focus and do things which might not be fun at the moment, but are critical for the success of the business. So we might change our strategy based on this feedback. I'm like consulting my partner right now, because we were planning on reworking the wizard, but perhaps what we should do is invoice integration. So we'll consider that in the upcoming days. Other than that, it's pretty intense. As I've kind of hinted on yesterday's video, there's tons of things going on at the moment. I'm taking on so many opportunities. So there's like gazillion projects that I'm starting to work on. I'm excited to share some of them with you guys in the upcoming weeks. So there's awesome things to be looking forward to. All right, hope you guys have a great day. I'll catch you tomorrow.